Down! Killing. Fading time. to feast. I'm still home.
Well, that was a T17 juiced abomination. Pretty smooth. It really depends on the rolls you put on the map. This one was quite reasonable. And then, what was the rolls again? I can't remember. It was quite reasonable, and then this farming strategy is pretty good for farming scarabs. And it's pretty cheap to run as well, I think. Let me just check right now how much all the scarabs cost. So I run a 1 gigantification, and that is 1/2 a chaos. And then 2 anarchies, that's half a chaos. That's 1 chaos, because each is half. And then I run this Beyond Scarab Invasion, which is also half a chaos. So all in all, this is a very, very cheap strategy. It's just a matter of whether or not you can run it. I also run anarchy on the crafting bench as well. So it's whether or not you can run it, because this is a tormented rogue strategy. So basically ghosts with rogues and elder altars, and then beyond as well. So beyond, I spawn a lot of beyond because of the beyond scarab invasion, and then with that you should have a lot of scarab drops because of the scarab tree, as well as a lot of these small scarab passives. Yeah, so yeah, pretty profitable. Drop basically 2.5 tabs of items, 3 tabs of items, most of them being scarabs. Let me just look at the map. Usually, because you know, chieftain doesn't die, this chieftain build is just really tanky and doesn't die. You can use all your 173 more scarabs and currency. What the hell? Anyway, yeah, so because you barely die, you can just basically use all your portals for dropping off your items. wait, I forgot what mods there were. So I can't remember. I don't think it was that difficult. It was like pretty reasonable. So number of rare monsters increase, monsters avoid ailments, monster damage, volatile barrels, ignite, freeze, and shock. Players cannot gain charges. Monsters have 2 additional modifiers. Actually, that's like some one of the best for farming. Anyway, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. The build hasn't actually changed. I haven't changed anything. The only thing I did was I went to standard and took all the divines I had, which is about 412, and traded it for a demigod's beacon skin, so I could change that into a compound skin. And then I moved it here as the shield, because I didn't really like the shield or how it looked. Like, this is the original shield. It looks pretty meh. So I went to standard and got the demigods, and then broke it down so it can fit in my character. Which, not too bad, looks quite nice. Alright, hope you enjoyed this video. See you, I'm out. Bye.